In our everyday life, we use the SI system for measuring stuff. This includes meters, seconds, kilograms, etc., since these quantities are relatable to us. It makes no sense to measure your height in nanometers or your weight in gigatons. For elementary particles, however, that's a whole different story. A proton weighs about 1.67 times 10 to the minus 27 kilograms. If we let go of the kilogram as our unit to measure stuff, we could express a proton's mass as about 1, with a unit called GeV. This seems much more practical, more natural. So how do we do this? The first step to natural units is to redefine some constants. Let's start with the speed of light. We define c equals 1, not 1 meter per second, just 1. What does it mean? Let's look at the equation more closely. Length equals time. Sounds confusing, but it's simple. If we define c equals 1, we can measure length in units of time and time in units of length. A second now refers to the distance that light travels in this 1 second. A person who is 1.8 meters tall might say that in natural units, he is 0.00000006 seconds tall. This is nowhere different than saying he's 5 feet 11. It's just another system of units. Setting c equals 1 also gives us a scale for velocities. Velocities now do not carry units anymore, they are implicitly given in units of the speed of light. A velocity of 0.4 means 0.4 times c. Let's do another constant. H bar is Planck's constant divided by 2 pi. It gets the same treatment, so h bar equals 1. What does this imply? Planck's constant is given in units of energy multiplied by time. Setting h bar equals to 1 means setting energy and inverse time on equal footing. Now you can express your h in inverse energy. And since energy is kilograms times velocity squared, and with c equals 1, velocities do not carry units anymore, kilograms can be expressed by energy. Now it's clear how we can express the mass of a proton with a unit of energy, that is GeV. To summarize, with c and h bar equal to 1, we have length equals time equals inverse mass. So we can describe length with seconds, time with inverse kilograms, etc. Remember, this all follows just from a different unit system. So far, we've set the speed of light and Planck's constant to 1. The term natural units, however, can mean several unit systems, depending on which constants were defined to be 1. Some people choose to also set Newton's gravitational constant, Boltzmann's constant, or other constants to 1. The more constants you set to 1, the more constants vanish from your equations, thus making them easier to look at. However, you cannot set any constant to 1. Say we choose the proton mass to be equal to 1. That means, if something has the mass 1.2, it has a mass of 1.2 times the proton mass. In this unit system, we are not able to also set the electron's mass to 1. This would lead to an ambiguity. What would m equals 10 mean? 10 times the proton mass? 10 times the electron mass? Let's finish with an example. What's the height of the Eiffel Tower in inverse nanograms using natural units where c and h bar equal 1?